Tennessee was members. Then the county sheriff in the state of Tennessee the same day. It's early Monday morning, August 7th, 2017, time 3:25 a.m. First, I thank y'all, my family, my support for your continued encouragement and support. Continue to keep myself employed right here in this Memphis tri-state area. We'll continue to further my education more localized online, pursuing my social degree, studying business administration, concentration, marketing. And the music in the background is Radio Africa Online. That's Radio Africa Online. And what I'm going to do right now is my Instagram. Hello, everybody. My name is Eric Johnson. Also, I'm going to write you out there right here in the city of Memphis. I'm going to count the shares in the state of Tennessee today and day. Early Monday morning, August 7th, 2017, time 3:27 a.m. First, I thank y'all for paying my support and continue to carry my support. I'm gonna do my faithful lie. Hello, everybody. My name is Eric D. Johnson, also known as Rashad. I'm here right here in the city of Memphis. And the county sheriff's in the state of Tennessee. Today's date is early Monday morning, August 7th, 2017. First, I thank you to all my fans, my support for your continued encouragement and support. And music in the background is Radio App Online. Thank you. go to TikTok and follow the trending music there. We're going to continue talking about African traditional religion. As you know, African traditional religion is being taught in institutions higher than the meaning of colleges and universities. In Southern Africa, you can earn a bachelor's degree, PhD study African traditional religion. Now, we're going to look at a map so we know where African, Sub-Saharan Africa is located. Now this is an African language distribution map. This is an African language distribution map. As you can see, the blue color represents the Afro-Asiatic. The yellow color represents the Nilo-Saharan. The dark orange color represents the Niger Congo A. The light orange color represents the Niger Congo B, the Bantu. This is the other half of the map. And over there on the side, it tells you what the colors represent. Blue color represent the Afro-Asiatic. The yellow color represent the Nilo-Saharan. The dark orange color represent the Niger Congo A. Light orange color represent the Niger Congo B and Bantu. The green color represents two groups of people. The Kwai people are the pastoralists. The Sand people are the hunter-gatherers. Over on the island of Madagascar, that purple lavender color is the Austronesian. The Austronesian are the people that live in Indonesia. And the people that live in Indonesia, they migrated, they settled, they colonized the island of Madagascar. They're not the reason they have the other island of Madagascar. This is a Niger Congo language distribution map. This is a Niger Congo language distribution map.
primary branch, your Volta color, your South Volta, Bantu, your Bantu, beside Bantu, your other East Bengal color, your West Bengal color, your Quack, your North Volta crew, Sanufo, your Girl Volta language, your Alabama, your Bunja language, your other primary branch, your Kordofan, your Mandy, your Atlantic, and your Dogon. This is a Niger Congo language distribution map. This is a Niger Congo language distribution map. Your Atlantic, Molo from Fule, your Mandy, Bambare, Malika, Manika, Nayule, your Kruk, your Gur, Mule, your Quay, Bali, Akan, and Ewa, your Dogon, your Hydro, your Anime, with your Bunja language, your Bayan, your Banda, and Zambi, your Kordofan, Kordofani, Nam, Bantor, Yahoo, and Igbo, your Bantor, Fang, Tiki, Lengale, Mongo, and Kondo, Congo, Choki, Lube, Uganda, Rwanda, Bundi, Sukume, Kikuyu, Bantu, Swahili, Makawe, Nyanche, Bembe, Shone, Tisange, Northern Soto, Zulu, Southern Soto, Kosa, Tiswane, Ndange, Mbundu. There are many other Niger Congo speaking groups people that are not mentioned on this map. Asiatic language distribution map. Afro-Asian, also known as Afro-Asian, traditionally as a Middo-Semitic, is a large language family of several hundred related languages and dialects. It comprises about 300 or so living languages and dialects. It includes languages spoken predominantly in West Asia, North Africa, Horn of Africa, and parts of the Sahel. Afro-Asiatic language families usually consider to include the following branches of Berber, Chadic, Cushitic, Egyptian, Omani, and Semitic. This is a Nilo-Saharan language distribution map. This is a Nilo-Saharan language distribution map. Nilo-Saharan languages are a whole family of African languages spoken by some 50 to 60 million people mainly in the upper parts of the Chari and Nile rivers, including historic Nubia, northern where the two tributaries of the Nile meet. The languages extend through 17 nations in the northern half of Africa, from Algeria to Benin, in the west from Libya to the Democratic Republic of Congo in the center, and from Egypt to Tanzania in the east. Nilo-Saharan major languages, Luo, Nuri, Sungay, Tiso, Nubian, Nubari, named by my Wida language. Lango, that's a Luo language. Dinka, Acholi, that's another Luo language. Nuo, Maasai, and Gambe, Fur, Tubu. It's a Nilo-Saharan language family. Books we're going to continue to read from and refer to is titled West African Traditional Religions, written by Dr. Joseph Omosei and related on Dr. Pink and Lumo the Penguin. Another book we're going to continue to read from and we're going to refer to is titled African Religions and Philosophy, written by Dr. John S. M. B. Another book we're going to continue to read from and we're going to refer to is titled Concepts of God in Africa, written by Dr. John S. M. B. adjust my chair. Now, I'm reading from the King James Holy Bible. Now, there are people that are trying to discourage you from reading the Holy Bible. They'll claim that the Holy Bible has been altered. It's been changed. It's been tampered with. As we've been talking about it, we know that people all over this planet communicate. Communication is broad. When you communicate, people all, like I said, people all over this planet, they have various ways of communicating. And communicating just didn't start with this generation. Communication went all the way back, way, way back, many, many years ago. We know that people, they left paintings on the wall, architecture. The archaeologists, they do all the digging in the ground, and all the different scientists that study the past. They study the past, people that lived in the past. They had various ways of communicating. And so when it comes to the mouth, what I'm saying? When you talk about the oral tradition, when you talk about the oral tradition, and one of the examples of the oral tradition is that we read the book of Genesis. To the very first chapter. There are very many instances. How did this, we don't have to ask how. God. There are many instances where God spoke. He said God created the heavens and the earth. Chapter 1, verse number 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. God created the heavens. He made the firmament and called it the heavens. And created the earth. And he created man, male and female. And created Adam. Created all the creatures, and God did all that. God created all that, and all this information. When it came to man, it was God talking to man. There was we don't really know how God communicated with man, with Adam, about the heavens and the earth. God created male and female, so God had to teach Adam about God. Adam just didn't come knowing who he was or what, about earth, about heaven, about good and evil. He had to be taught by God. And the oral tradition is the foundation of the Bible, the oral tradition. And it says that God made man from the dust of the ground. See, this is the oral tradition. And then it talks about how Adam was put to sleep, and God made Eve from a rib in his body. And she shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Read the Bible. Don't be discouraged. And then it talks about how Adam called his wife. You know, Adam and Eve became, so a man called his wife Eve. That's the oral tradition. We know that Adam, Eve, and the serpent were punished by God for being defiant, being disobedient. And that, you know, and then it was passed on to the next generation. All this information was passed from Adam and Eve to the next generation, and generations on, even to the day. Now let's turn over to Genesis, the book. Online, we use the Facebook Live, then we use Periscope yesterday, we use YouTube, we use the internet, the World Wide Web, and so on. And we know that Bible study tools is one of the things that we use, and Bible Gateway is another website we use. It's available, you know. Bible study tools. They have all the verses of the Bible, including the other books of the Bible. Now they're a little limited on the language translation. But then we have Bible Gateway. They have all the verses of the Bible, including all the other books of the Bible. But they're more, they have more language translations of the Bible, you know, Bible Gateway, from A to Z. So when we read scriptures, people in all over the world can follow along. Now, what we're going to do right now, we're going to read, we're going to go to the book of Genesis, chapter 6, the flood story. Now, the flood story is Genesis chapter 6, 7, and 8. Read the whole chapter. Read the whole chapter. I'm in chapter, Genesis chapter 6. I'm going to read verses 5 through 13. And God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continued. And they repented the Lord that he had made man on earth, and he grieved him in his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing, and the fowls of the earth, for repent of me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. These are the generations of Noah. Noah was a just man, and perfect in his generation. Noah walked with God. And Noah begat three sons of Shem, Ham, and Japheth. The earth also was corrupt before God, and the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt. For all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth, and God said unto Noah, the end of all flesh is come before me, for the earth is filled with violence through them. And behold, I will destroy them with the earth. So read the flood story. The book of Genesis, chapter 6, 7, let's go to the New Testament. The Beatitudes. The book of Matthew, chapter 5, 6, and 7. Read the whole chapter. The Beatitudes. And also the book of Luke. Luke chapter 6, read the whole chapter. Read the whole chapter. The Beatitudes. Verses 20 through 49. When it comes to John the Baptist, the book of Matthew, chapter 3, verses 1 through 17, emphasize verses 11 through 17. Now, the book of Mark, chapter 1, verses 1 through 11, emphasize verses 7 through 11. The book of Luke, chapter 3, verses 1 through 22, emphasize verses 16 through 22. The book of John, chapter 1, verses 15 through 34. Emphasize verses 26 through 34. Jesus begins his ministry. The book of Matthew, chapter 4, verses 12 through 25. Emphasize verses 23 through 25. Now, I'm reading verse 17 in Matthew chapter 4. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Now, I'm going to move up here to 23 through 25, chapter 4, Matthew chapter 4, verses 23 through 25. And Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogue, and preaching the gospel of the kingdom, and healing all manner of sickness and all manner of disease among the people. And his fame went throughout all Syria, and they brought unto him all sick people that were taken with divers diseases and torments, and those which were possessed with devils, and those which were lunatic, and those that had the palsy. And he healed them. And there followed him great multitude of people from Galilee, and from Decapolis, and from Jerusalem, from Judea, and from beyond Jordan. You have a description of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. He did a lot of healing. You know, all manner of sicknesses and diseases. All these people that were walking around with lunatics. People who were possessed with devils. And, you know, Jesus healed all these people. And also, the book of Mark, chapter 1, verses 14 through 45. Emphasize verses 14, 39 through 45. The book of Luke, chapter 4. Verses 14 through 44, emphasize verses 15, 43, and 44. The book of John, chapter 1, verses 35 through 51. Jesus teaching in the synagogue. The book of Matthew, chapter 4, verse 23. The book of Mark, chapter 1, verse 21. The book of Luke, chapter 4, verse 15. The book of John, chapter 6, verse 59. Jesus chose 12 disciples. The book of Matthew, chapter 10, verses 1 through 42. The book of Mark, chapter 3, verses 13 through 35. The book of Luke, chapter 6, verses 13 through 49. Let me turn it down. Now we'll read verse 13. We'll read from the book of Luke, chapter 6, verse 13. unto him his disciples, and of them he chose 12, whom also he named apostles. The book of John, chapter 6, verses 32 through 71. And also, Jesus established the church. Let's turn to the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verses 13 through 19. Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi. He asked his disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" And they said, "Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said unto them, "But whom say ye that I am?" And Simon Peter answered and said, "Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered and said unto them, "Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood have not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. And I say unto thee that thou art Peter, and upon this rock I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. And I will give unto thee the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever thou shalt loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven." Matthew chapter 18, verses 15 through 20. "Moreover, if thy brother shall trespass against thee, go and tell him his fault between thee and him alone. If he shall hear thee, thou hast gained thy brother. But if he will not hear thee, then take with thee one or two more, that in the mouth of two or three witnesses every word may be established. And if he shall neglect to hear them, tell it unto the church. But if he neglect to hear the church, let him be unto thee as a heathen man and a publican. Verily I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever ye shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again I say unto you, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. Where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." The death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, our Lord and Savior. The book of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 1, verses 1 through 75. The book of Matthew, chapter 27, verses 1 through 66. Emphasize verses 50. Jesus gave up the ghost. And verses 57 through 60. One of his disciples, Joseph of Arimathea, took his body down from the cross. Matthew, chapter 28, verses 1 through 20. Emphasize verses 16 through 20. The book of Mark, chapter 14, verses 1 through 72. The book of Mark, chapter 15, verses 1 through 47. Emphasize verses 37. Jesus Christ gave up the ghost in verses 43 through 47. One of his disciples, Joseph of Arimathea, took his body down from the cross. Mark, chapter 16, verses 1 through 20. Emphasize verses 14 through 20. The book of Luke, chapter 22, verses 1 through 71. The book of Luke, chapter 23, verses 1 through 56. Emphasize verse 46, Jesus Christ gave up the ghost. And verses 50 through 56, one of his disciples, Joseph of Arimathea, took his body down from the cross. verses 44 through 53. The book of John, chapter 17, verses 1 through 26, we'll turn to it. We're in the book of John, chapter 17, verses 1 through 26. These words speak Jesus and lifted up his eyes to heaven and said, Father, the hour has come. Glorify thy Son, that thy Son also may glorify thee. And thou hast given him power over all flesh, that he should give eternal life to as many as thou hast given him. And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent. I have glorified thee on the earth. I have finished the work which thou gavest me to do. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thy own self with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. I have manifested thy name unto the men which thou gavest me out of the world. Thine they were, and thou gavest them me, and they have kept thy word. Now they have known that all things whatsoever thou hast given me are of thee. For I have given unto them the words which thou gavest me, and they have received them, and have known surely that I came out from thee, and they have believed that thou didst send me. I pray for them, I pray not for the world, but for them which thou hast given me, for they are thine. And all mine are thine, and thine are mine, and I am glorified in them. And now I am no more in the world, but these are in the world. And I come to thee, Holy Father, keep through thine own name those whom thou hast given me, that they may be one as we are. While I was with them in the world, I kept them in thy name. Those that thou gavest me I have kept, and none of them is lost, but the Son of Perdition, that the scripture might be fulfilled. And now come I to thee, and these things I speak in the world, that they might have my joy fulfilled in themselves. I have given them thy word, and the world have hated them, because they are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. I pray not that thou shouldest take them out of the world, but that thou shouldest keep them from the evil. They are not of the world, even as I am not of the world. Sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. If thou hast sent me into the world, even so have I also sent them into the world. And for their sakes I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. Neither pray I for these alone, but for them also which shall believe on me through their word, that they all may be one, as thou, Father, art in me, and I in thee, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that thou hast sent me. And the glory which thou gavest me I have given them, that they may be one, even as we are one, I in them and thou in me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that thou hast sent me, and hast loved them that thou hast loved me. Father, I will that they also, whom thou hast given me, be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory, which thou hast given me, for thou lovest me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, the world have not known thee, but I have known thee. And these have known that thou hast sent me, and I have declared unto them thy name. And I will declare it, that the love wherewith thou hast loved me may be in them, and I in them. Also, the book of John, chapter 18, verses 1 through 40. The book of John, chapter 19, verses 1 through 42, emphasize verse 30. Jesus Christ gave up the ghost. In verses 38 through 42, a disciple of Jesus Christ, Joseph of Arimathea, took his body down from the cross. John chapter 20, verses 1 through 31. And John chapter 21, verses 1 through 25. Jesus gives apostles commission. We're going to turn over to the book of Matthew, chapter 28, verses 16 through 20. disciples went away into Galilee into a mountain where Jesus had appointed them. And when they saw him, they worshipped him, but saw him down. And Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Go ye therefore and teach all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Spirit and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. The book of Mark, chapter 16, verses 14 through 20. We're in the book of Mark, chapter 16, verses 14 through 20. Afterward, he appeared unto the 11 as they sat at meat, and upbraided them with their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they believed not them which had seen them after he was risen. And he said unto them, go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He that believeth and is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. So then, after the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat on the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere. The Lord worked with them and confirmed the word. Word is signs followed. Amen. Turn to the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 44 through 49. In the book of Luke, chapter 24, verses 44 through 49. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses, and the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then open ye their understanding, that they might understand the scripture, and said unto them, thus it is written, and thus it behooved Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in his name among all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things, and behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you. But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. John chapter 21. Read the whole chapter. Now, we're going to turn to the book of Acts. Read the whole book, the Acts of the Apostles. Read the whole book. Don't skip around. Don't pick little scriptures and things. Read the whole book of Acts. Now, churches such as the Catholic Church, the Eastern Orthodox Church, the Church of Christ, the Baptist Church, the the Methodist Church, the Presbyterian Church, the Episcopalian Church, the Lutheran Church, the Calvin Church, the Church of England, the Jehovah's Witness, Mormon, the Latter-day Saints, the Assemblies of God, the Church of God, the Church of God in Christ, all man-made church, and based on, let me read the epistle that Paul wrote, Saul from Tarsus, and then they're saying in the churches of Christ. That's what they, that's what all these man-made churches, we call them churches of Christ. And I read the whole book of Acts, like I say. Now, we know that the first place that you see in the Bible, where it says Christian, is in Acts chapter 11. Acts chapter 11, verse 26. And when he had found him, he brought him unto Antioch, and it came to pass that a whole year they assembled themselves with the church and taught much people. And the disciples were called Christians first in Antioch. And then another place is Acts chapter 26. Chapter 26, verse 28. Then Agrippa said unto Paul, almost thou persuade me to be a Christian. And then another place is first Peter. Suffer as a Christian, let him not be ashamed, but let him glorify God on his behalf. It's all lies. Every place that you see talking about being a Christian is a lie. It's a lie. And also about those epistles. Second Peter. Chapter 3. Verses 15 through 18. And accounted the loss of my Lord and salvation, even as our beloved brother Paul, also according to the wisdom given unto him, hath written unto you, as also in all his epistles, speaking of him of these things, which are some things hard to be understood, which they that are unlearned and unstable rest, as they do also the other scriptures, unto their own destruction. Ye therefore, beloved, seeing ye know these things before, beware, lest ye also be led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfast. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, to him be glory, both now and forever. Amen. When it comes to 1st and 2nd Peter, the very first verse, the first epistle of Peter, chapter 1, verse number 1. Peter, an apostle of Jesus Christ, to the strangers scattered throughout Pontus, Galatia, Cappadocia, Asia, and Bithynia. The apostle Peter is an apostle of Jesus Christ. He entitled to respect. Now, we just read in the book of John what Jesus Christ said about all his apostles. They were given to him by God. The second epistle of Peter, chapter 1, verse number 1. Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have obtained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior, Jesus Christ. The apostle Peter is an apostle of Jesus Christ. He did not tell you to be a Christian. He did not tell you that those epistles that Paul wrote, beloved brother Paul, you understand? You have to understand that Paul has accountability and responsibility. He is an apostle of Jesus Christ. He entitled to respect. He entitled to respect. Now, Paul is a liar. My opinion, the devil. We're finna go down now. We're finna go to the book of Acts. And we're finna show you that Saul from Tarsus is a liar, a thief, a murderer, the devil. Don't read those epistles. You don't need to read those epistles. Anything, everything he wrote is a lie. Read the book of Hebrews, the book of James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John, the book of Jude, the epistle of Jude. Read the book of Revelation and read the book of Acts, the whole chapter, the whole book from start to end. Read the whole book of Acts. Read the book of Acts of the Apostle, chapter 1. We'll start at verse number 4. Chapter 1. And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which said, He, ye have heard of me. For John truly baptized with water, but ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. When they therefore were come together, they asked of him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom to Israel? And he said unto them, It is not for you to know the times or the season which the Father hath put in his own power. But ye shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, and ye shall be witnesses unto me both in Jerusalem and all Judea and in Samaria, and into the uttermost part of the earth. And when they had spoken these things while they were here, he was taken up, and a cloud received him out of their sight. Now I'm going to start reading that verse number 12. Then returned they unto Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem a 7 days journey. And when they were coming in, they went up into an upper room, whereby both Peter and James and John and Andrew, Philip and Thomas, Bartholomew and Matthew, James the son of Alphaeus, and Simon Zelotes, and Judas the brother of James, these all continued with one accord in prayer and supplication with the women, and Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brethren. And in those days, Peter stood up in the midst of the disciples and said, The number of names together were about 120. Men and brethren, this scripture of needs had been fulfilled, which the Holy Ghost by the mouth of David spake before concerning Judas, which was a guide to them that took Jesus before he was numbered with us and obtained part of his ministry. Now this man perfectly filled with the reward of iniquity had fallen here, and he burst the sun in the midst, and all his bowels gushed out, and it was known unto all the dwellers of Jerusalem, and so much as the field is called in their proper tongue, Hasadame, that is to say the field of blood, for it is written in the book of Psalms, let his habitation be desolate, and let no man dwell therein, and his bishopric let another take. Wherefore, of these men which have company with us all the time, that the Lord Jesus went in and out among us, beginning from the baptism of John until that same day that he was taken up from us, must one be ordained to be a witness with us of his resurrection. And they surname Justice and Matthias, and they prayed and said, Thou Lord, which know of the hearts of all men, shoot whether these two thou hast chosen, that they may take part of this ministry and apostleship on this Judas now transgression field, that he might go to his own place. And they gave forth their lots, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was numbered with the 11 apostles. Now, the book of Acts, chapter 2, verses 1 through 47, emphasize verses 1, 2, and 47. The book of Acts, chapter 3, verses 1 through 26. The book of Acts, chapter 4, verses 1 through 37. Chapter 5, verses 1 through 42. Chapter 6, verses 1 through 15, emphasize verses 1, 2, and 7. Because in those places, that's where they said the disciples. Chapter 7, verses 1 through 60. Chapter 8, verses 1 through 4, emphasize verses 5 through 24, and verses 26 through 40. Acts chapter 9, verses 1 through 43, emphasize verses 1 through 18, 19, 25, 26, 27, 31, 32 through 35, and also verses 36 through 43, that's where it talks about Tabitha, the name of Dorcas. She was a disciple. Acts chapter 10, verses 1 through 48. Acts chapter 11, verses 1 through 13, emphasize verses 1 through 18, 19 through 21, 26, 29, and 30. And Acts chapter 12, verses 1 through 25, emphasize verses 12, 24 and 25. Acts chapter 13, verses 1 through 52, emphasize verse 13 and verse 52. Acts chapter 14, verses 1 through 28, emphasize verses 20, 22, 23, 27, and 28. Acts chapter 15, verses 1 through 41, emphasize verses 1 through 11, verse number 10, 13 through 21, 22 through 29, 30 through 34, and 35 through 41. Acts chapter 16, verses 1 through 40, emphasize verses 1, 4, and 5. Chapter 17, verses 1 through 34. Acts chapter 18, verses 1 through 28, emphasize verse 27. Talking about the disciples. Chapter 19, verses 1 through 41, emphasize verses 1, 9, and 30. Chapter 20, verses 1 through 38. Emphasize verses 1, 7, and 30. Chapter 21, verses 1 through 40. Emphasize verses 4 and 16. Acts chapter 22, verses 1 through 30. Emphasize verses 25 through 30. Now the other chapters of in the book of Acts, as you know, once you get past to a certain point, you don't hear anything about the disciples or the church or anything. It's just about Paul, and he'd be around the Romans, and, you know, he talk about his conversion and things this nature. And like I said, he lied to King Agrippa, and King Agrippa told me he was almost persuaded to be a Christian. You know, it's a lie. How is it that this man could talk about being converted? See, this is how you know you're a liar. He claims to be talking about being converted. Now, we know that there was disciples in Damascus when he got knocked down on the road by our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the Son of God. There were disciples in Damascus here. And, you know, he sits there and he tells the centurion he's a Roman. He never, not one time, did he say he was a disciple. Not one time. And let us not forget that he reconciled with John. He never reconciled with Barnabas. He was going around with Silas. Barnabas and John was going in another direction. So, everywhere they went, they would tell people about what happened, about Paul, Saul, and Tarsus. Silas knew about it. So he was going around with Saul from Tarsus, Paul. So he would inform the people everywhere everywhere him and Saul went. He's a liar. He lied. He lied. When he claimed he was telling everybody about being converted, he the devil. He never repented. He never repented. United States government passed the Organized Crime Control Act of 1970 and Title IX of the Organized Crime Control Act, the Racketeer Influence and Corrupt Organization Act, or the RICO Act. It also the Comprehensive Drug Abuse Prevention and Control Act of 1970. The Controlled Substance Act, the Psychotropic Substances Act, the Continuing Criminal Enterprise Statute, or the Kingpin Statute, all this is anti-gang. It's all anti-gang. The Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention Act of 1974 established the Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention, plus other related legislation. The Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, the Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention, and Comprehensive Gang Mob, the Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention. The Bureau of Justice Assistance, Office of Justice Program, and the United States Department of Justice. You can go to the youth.gov and you can be informed about the Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, as well as the Comprehensive Gang Mob. Now, the Office of Justice Program, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, United States Department of Justice, Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, and Project Safe Neighborhood. United States Department of Justice, Office of Community-Oriented Police and Service, Comprehensive Anti-Gang Initiative, the Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention, United States Department of Justice, Office of Justice Program, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, the International Narcotics and Law Enforcement Affairs, United States Department of State, Institute for Intergovernmental Affairs, Gang Resistance, Education and Training, and Great Program. United States Department of Justice, Office of Justice Program, the Office of Juvenile Justice Delinquency Prevention, in October 2009, the National Youth Gang Center, which had been funded by the Office of Juvenile Justice Delinquency Prevention since 1995, merged with the National Gang Center, which had been funded by the Bureau of Justice Assistance since 2003. National Gang Center, compilation of state laws against gang. You can go to the National Gang Center website and be informed about the compilation of state laws against gangs. Gang Prevention Overview Research Program. This is James E. Howe, Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention. United States Department of Justice, Bureau of Justice Assistance, Office of Juvenile Justice and Delinquency Prevention. National Gang Center Bulletin. A History of Street Gangs in the United States. Read the books in the bulletin. And also you can go to Wikipedia and the same information. Type of gangs in the United States. The United States Department of Justice, Office of the United States Attorney, Man 1457, Criminal Street Gang Statute 18, United States Code 521. The United States Department of Justice, Federal Bureau of Investigating National Gang Intelligence Center. United States Department of Justice, Organized Crime and Gang Section, and other federal, state, and local agencies. United States Department of Justice, Office of Justice Program, National Institute of Justice, Anti-Gang Strategies, Prevention, Intervention, Assessment, and Suppression. United States Department of Justice, Office of Justice Program, National Institute of Justice, United States Department of Health and Human Services, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, National Center for Injury Prevention and Control, Change of Course. Prevented gang membership. also strive, striving to reduce youth violence everywhere. United States Department of Justice and the United States Department of Education, United States Department of Health and Human Services, United States Department of Housing and Urban Development, United States Department of Labor, and the White House Office of National Drug Control Policy, National Forum on Youth Violence Prevention. You can go to youth.gov and be informed by the National Forum on Youth Violence Prevention, the United States Department of Justice, the Bureau of Justice Assistance, National Crime Prevention Council, keeping kids out of gangs, and also anti-hazing. You can go to lawyers.com and be informed about anti-hazing. Coercion, sexual coercion, psychological coercion, psychological manipulation, psychological abuse. Coercion, coerce, sexual coercion, psychological coercion, psychological manipulation, psychological abuse. Get ready to end today's video. Again, my name is Eric B. Jones, also known as Bryce Allen. I live right here in the city of Memphis. It's in the county of Shelby, within the state of Tennessee. I thank all my fans, my support, for your team, encouragement, and support. Like I stated on my Periscope video yesterday, not saying I'm never do another video, just saying that strong possibility I'm going to work another job instead of working one job or two jobs. So, it'll be kind of hard to try. I won't have time to do a long video like I've been doing. Probably at the most 5 minutes. I'm gonna be past no 30 minutes. I still make a video just to stay in contact with my fans, my support, and wish each and every one of you the best. Take care of yourself, and always put God